地球に突如未知の敵対生物イーバが襲来。その強大な攻撃により世界各国は次々と壊滅。アメリカの大地もその7割がイーバの巣となった。現存する兵器すべてがイーバに対し効果を示さず、一方的な蹂躙は続き、疲弊しきった人類は滅亡の危機に瀕していた。しかしついに人類は一つの対抗手段を手に入れる。イーバの体組織と金属を結合させた生体武装を開発。この武装を改造手術で組み込んだ特殊強化兵部隊アンチが誕生した。アンチの死闘により人類は初めてイーバ・バロン級を駆逐することに成功。この戦果をきっかけに人類は大規模な反抗作戦に乗り出した。アンチという新たな力に望みをかけて。
これより諸君に本作戦の概要を説明する。作戦名はオペレーション・ドーン・オブ・ジ・アース、地球の夜明け作戦。これは世界各地に存在するイーバ生息圏、通称ネストのうちの一つ、アラスカネスト内に位置する敵エネルギー輸送プラントを露覚し、イーバ母星へ進攻することを目的とした大規模作戦である。本作戦はニューヨーク、ウィスコンシンを攻略し、カナダを経て最終目的地であるアラスカ到達を目指す。特殊強化兵部隊は第7艦隊の砲撃開始と同時にニューヨークネスト上空から強襲を敢行。全隊員の降下を確認後、ニューヨークネストの中心グランドターミナルを占拠するバロン級イーバケルベロスの討伐へ向かえ。それでは諸君らの奮闘に期待する。
地べたを這いずり回るだけの時はおしまいだ。血をかけ、敵を見つけ、奴らを殲滅する。さあ、人類反撃の狼煙を上げろ。全隊、こちらビクター1、全員の降下を確認した。現時刻よりグランドターミナルに向け進軍を開始せよ。
いい感じじゃねえか。 体だけが鳥へのワニ野郎だ。やっぱくせ、そこを削り取ってやれ。やっぱくせ、
休んでる暇はないぞ。敵に囲まれたら急いで切り抜けろ。この先グランドターミナル構内にバロン級の反応あり、発見次第殲滅せよ。
まずは、怪異の首から破壊しろ。
HQ、こちらビクター1バルン級ウィーバー、ケルベロスの沈黙を確認した。
諸君、ご苦労。回収部隊を要請した。まずは次の作戦まで待機とする。先の戦いご苦労だった。ニューヨーク奪還作戦は成功だ。これにより人類は反撃への第一歩を踏み出した。以後このアンダーグラウンドネットワークをウィスコンシン攻略に使用するため、地下網内の敵残存勢力および地形確認の調査を、歩兵第三大隊および偵察小隊は先行して地下網調査を開始せよ。特殊強化兵部隊は次の任務に備え自身の強化に努めるよう。
分かっていると思うが、我々アンチの装備は特殊な生体武装だ。故に一般兵とは違い武装の配給は行われない。より強力な武器を得たいなら自分で用意するんだ。分かったな。
取れているか。よし、俺が生きているうちにこの戦いの記録を残しておく。俺たちアンチの力は絶大だ。この絶望的な状況を覆せるかもしれない。新兵たち、ジョニー、トーマスでさえ強化兵となった途端一般兵とは比べ物にならない戦力になった。ニューヨーク奪還が成功してから部隊の士気も高まっている。希望が見えてきた。俺たちはきっとイーバに勝てるはずだ。
Our story begins in the middle of the 40s, when a hopeful young soldier called Sam... we're not doing that? Our story begins in the middle of last Tuesday, where a hopeless young freeloader called Sam is sipping a fancy cup of coffee with a name nobody can pronounce. Sam was born with a silver spoon in his mouth. But not the actual spoon that he has in his mouth now. That is a different spoon. But a figurative spoon that represents all the wealth and attention that he has been receiving from his parents. And their butlers. and their butler's parents. You're a douche, aren't you, Sam? Blink twice if yes. He can't hear me. This is Sam's girlfriend, also not being heard by Sam. She's mad at Sam for his lack of responsibility produced by his large wealth. She also mentions the fact that Sam has forgotten her birthday for the third year in a row. Sam's girlfriend is upset. As with most rich and famous brats, Sam does not pick up on that. Instead, he decides to lay this gem.
Things just work out for me, baby. I can't just run around and do stuff. I'd end up with a limp spine
then,
or something.
Sam's girlfriend does something she should have done a long time ago. Sam is laying unconscious on the floor. He gathers his strength and makes an effort to get up. Then he makes another effort to stand up straight. Sam is hit in the head so hard, he has to remind himself how to walk. He takes a right step. Then he takes a left step. Good job, Sam! You're very good at existing.
Huh? How dare you startle my child?
An overprotective mother hurls a cup of coffee in Sam's face. He has to blink rapidly to regain his vision.
Say something, Harold!
Oh, gee.
Sam remembers the one thing he's good at.
Son, going
paying for stuff. So he turns around to pay for his beverage.
I thought he was gonna become an actor.
Oh, what's the difference?
Sam pays the guy 500 euros, barely covering the coffee.
Thanks for the tip, douchebag.
Sam decides to hurl another 500 at the guy. Not such a douchebag after all. Sam is hurling stacks of 500s left and right. He has no perception of money. Sam is about to spend his whole weekly allowance on tipping a barista named Tony. He really was hit hard in the head. Sam spends a decade making his way out the door, which is pretty good for a guy with a major concussion. As Sam waggles outside, he sees his girlfriend on the other side of the road. Sam pulls himself together and rushes towards his soon-to-be ex-girlfriend. This is when a septic tank truck approaches Sam with an average speed of 90 kilometers per hour. The impact renders him 8 types of dead. A bottle to the face would result in such a terrible fate for Sam. But a bottle won't be the only thing that will meet Sam's face today. There's also the ground in hell. Sam does not like being dead a single bit. He also hates the eerie feeling of not having any cash on him. Then, he finds 7 glowing notes in his pocket. That makes him feel reasonably better. The source of the sound is none other than obliteration and oblivion, extermination and extinction, the end, decease and demise, the Grim Reaper, death. He's trying to do a kickflip on a skateboard and is dressed like a douchebag for some reason. In his coarse, horrifying voice, he lays this on Sam.
Yo, yo, yo! You must be Sam from the info I was provided.
Then he takes a second look at Sam and his eye sockets widen.
Holy feces, dude! Your soul be like a diamond! Let me cut you a deal that we can seal. For reals? Aight, man, it decided.
The notes in Sam's pocket are something called a shred of life. Every soul has at least one, and it is the biggest unit in Hell's currency, followed by quality of life, school of life, sound of life, meaning of life, and thug life.
If you give me your shreds, I'll resurrect your face and get you out of Hell on one condition. You'll have to survive 24 hours with a handicap I choose under my supervision, bro.
Sam decides to check out the rest of Hell before doing any deals with supernatural beings.
Why, hello there, dear sir. Let's see if we can find a job for you. You get to be... ooh, a plumber. That'll be all your shreds, dear sir.
All right, that sounds fair. Yes.
Sam notices that the souls that get into Hell are forced to get a job and become functioning souls of society. For most people, this is okay, but for Sam, it's horrifying. He hurls his shreds at death like he's never hurled piles of money before.
Why, hello there, dear sir. Let's see if we can find a job for you. You get to be... ooh, a minesweeper. That'll be all your shreds, dear sir.
Could be worse. Whatever. Kinda sounds fun.
Why, hello there, dear sir. Let's see if we can find a job for you. You get to be a struggling freelance artist. Oh my, that'll be all your shreds.
He keeps the last shred for the next time he meets the gatekeeper of Hell. Whenever that's going to be.
Heh heh. Aight, bro. I only get to do these deals annually. But if you really want to live in biz, you have to do it manually. Also, I will stop speaking in rhymes now.
Sam has just traveled through time, space, and logic, and finds himself fully alive, and more importantly, rich again. His joy is only dimmed by the fact that he can't move at all. This is when he shows up. Death.
Yo, yo, yo! Oh, God, you look horrible. I mean, you look great, bro. You be okay? Can you hear me? Blink twice if yes. Oh, cool. You'll be alive. Everything be fine. Aight, so this here be the dealing biz. All your body functions be manual, so you kinda have to do stuff on purpose. You be turning kinda blue. Might wanna consider breathing. All right, bitchin'. You be blinking and breathing. That be bitchin'. So, all right. Go survive for a day, and I'll let you live normally for the rest of your life. If you somehow die within the next 24 hours, you'll go to Hell and I'll keep your shreds forever. I'll be over there doing kickflips if you need me.
once again, Sam has to make an effort to get up. This time, he has to focus on his spine. And once again, he has to remind himself how to walk.
Oh, by the way, dude, you be getting late for work.
Sam does something that resembles walking toward the bathroom.
Gonna do a kickflip now. Nyah! Friggin' skateboard. Aye, let's see.
Sam has some trouble with his posture and has to focus on his spine.
Aye, let's see.
Sam has some trouble with his posture and has to focus on his spine. Sam's vision is blurrier than a Norwegian teenager at a wedding. He decides to blink. Sam tries to take a leak.
Hey, dude, have you seen my...
Sam takes a leak everywhere, including, but not limited to, himself. One empty bladder later, Sam moves on. Blink, Sam! Blink! Sam has some trouble with his posture and has to focus on his spine. Sam tries to take a shower. He looks like a mantis that's trying to explain to someone how a bicycle works. Sam is clean as a whistle. Good job, Sam. Blink, Sam, blink! Your spine, Sam! It matters! Blink, Sam, blink!
Gonna do a kickflip now. Friggin' skateboard. Aye, let's see.
Sam nearly forgets to brush his teeth, but his pursuit of bearable breath isn't over yet.
Aye, let's see.
Blink, Sam, blink!
Relax my body. Bend in my knees. Oh, what I be doing wrong, yo? Let's see.
Sam holds on to that toothbrush like his life depends on it. Then he lets go. How sad. Blink, Sam, blink! With clean, Sam is dumb enough to breathe in with his mouth full of water. He has to cough. Clean and empty, Sam decides to find some clues. Blink, Sam! Blink!
Friggin' skateboard. Aye, let's see. Yeah! Yeah!
Sam can open doors now. Clever boy. Sam enters his wardrobe. What will he wear today? How hard is it to blink, Sam? He picks a pair of blue jeans. The ugly ones. Sam successfully puts on his pants. Feeling more accomplished than ever, he proceeds to find a jacket. Only the best one will do. He settles for a mediocre one. Humble. Fully clothed, Sam is ready for the day. P.S. He's not. He puts on his shoes, living the dream of having shoes on. Sam walks down the stairs with great precision. Flappy Rooster is Sam's favorite game. He has no time for playing with a Flappy Rooster right now, though.
Following the story at this time, and gang wars are still an escalating problem at Bridge Street, where the police are struggling to regain control. Commuters are advised to...
Hey, Lucy, I'm home!
Oh, hey, dude. Still alive, huh?
Thank you.
There is a note saying, sent over a maid to make you breakfast. Don't breathe in while chewing. Love, Mom. Despite his mother's warnings, Sam breathes in. Disgusting, but necessary. Sam passes out from the lack of oxygen. It's going to be a long day. Sam finishes his food like the big boy he is. Good job, Sam. He finally makes it out the front door. Beaten. Terrified. Stupid. Sam passes out from the lack of oxygen again. Sam has just traveled through time, space, and long. He finally makes it out the front door. Beaten. Terrified. Stupid.
Dude, I am totally gonna kickflip over your car.
Oh, dang! Man, that hurt. Dude, it was like that when I got there. You might want to get that hood fixed. It be loose. I'll just get in the car, yo. Hey, dude. I turned your automatic gearbox into a manual one for the funds. That be ironic or what?
At this point, Sam notices that Death isn't really a nice guy.
I guess I should teach you how to drive a stick, huh? Aight, so, when starting the car, you want to press down the clutch pedal.
Nobody has clutched anything for years. Good luck, Sam.
Now, while you have the clutch down, press the gas pedal. As you let go of the clutch, the car will start moving them bits. Press down the clutch, then the gas, and then let go the clutch pedal. Jeez! Good job, dude. You ain't as useless as you look, know what I mean? Now, to stop, you gotta move your right foot to the brake pedal.
Left for us, he means.
And obviously, press it down. Give stopping a go, dude. Nice! Now, start driving again, like I showed you. And obviously. You turn left and right with your arms. If you want to drive faster, you gotta use the stick, baby. To upshift, you press down the clutch and then yank the stick. Obviously, you can't turn left when your hand be on the stick. So to turn left, you have to move your hand back to the steering wheel, y'all.
And so Sam and the Lord of Damnation are on their merry way towards a new adventure. Together. Cozy.
Dude, there be an old lady on the road. Y'all go right. We almost killed that lady. She ain't due for another... a few hours.
Listen, if you kill somebody before their time because I messed up your motoring skills, I will be in deep feces, okay? So keep your eyes on the road. If you almost kill someone, I'll stop the car, yo. But then, you'll have to start it all over again with the clutching bits, right? You'd be good to go.
Anyway, dude, you're probably wondering why all this biz be happening to you. To tell you the truth, bro, it be all part of bureaucratic bull feces. The shreds of life you give to those gatekeepers to get into hell, yeah, they be distributed between the bank of hell and Satan. Oh, yeah, dude, the big S. Then, the bank of hell distributes their share as right, yo. Holy feces! Anyway. Then, the Bank of Hell distributes their share as salary among the citizens of Hell. Do you know how much my salary be? A little less than a burger flipper at Mickey Demons, yo, and a little more than an elementary school teacher. You know what I be saying? Up high. Never mind. A soul has one...
Right, dude? Close one!
I was saying, a soul has one, maybe two shreds on him, depending on his life quality. And I don't want to point fingers, but someone here be a spoiled brat, bro. Dude, you had seven shreds. You have any idea how rare that be? I be scamming, I mean making right, yo. No, sir. As I was saying, I be scamming, I mean making deals with bratty souls that have more than two shreds of life for an eternity, yo. And I only got 295 shreds of life, bro.
Sam passes out from lack of air. No one notices.
Skeletons for the win, right, dude? Yo, 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 death for life.
Wiki, 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 wiki.
Death for life, yo. Yo, skeletons, FT dub. What be that gray cloud in the middle of the road?
Sam passes out from lack of air. No one notices.
Get ready! Right. Ah! Yo, go left!
Ah!
Right.
Oh!
Left.
Ah!
Yo! Right. What be up with all those old ladies today, bro? Hey, Sam, you're never gonna make it to work on time with all these grannies everywhere, dude. What do you say we take a shortcut? Go left.
And so Sam drives the car to a place he has never been before. A place called Bridge Street.
Oh, dude. I hope it be safe here. Hope there be no, say, crazy gang members here or nothing. No, really, though. Where be the crazy gang members? Oh, crazy gang members. Oh, excuse me. You be a crazy gang member? Ooh, don't you worry. I know where the crazy gang members be.
To Death's surprise and Sam's relief, the gang members are lying dead on the ground. This is when Death notices a distinct silhouette in the distance.
What be the deal, bro? Why be there?
The silhouette is contention and enmity, bloodshed and hostility, strife and strike, struggle, battle, war. She is neither wearing dumb clothes nor doing kickflips. She is just standing there after a job well done.
Oh, holy feces, it be her! I'll be my breath. Just be cool.
Be cool! Okay, just don't be yourself. Hey, war, how it be going, babe? Wanna hit your ride in these sweet wheels? Oh, holy feces, here she comes. Hey, girl, where to?
Just shut up and take me to the metro. Aren't you supposed to, like, reap a bunch of people, you knucklehead?
I was. But then I got bored, so now I hang out with my buddy Sammy here.
Ain't it right, Sammy?
Stop here. Stop.
Oh, God!
Okay, let's go. So instead of guiding endless amounts of confused souls to the afterlife, you waste time with this dumb, ugly mortal. Stop here. Okay, we can go.
You want a cigarette?
Ugh, you are so annoying. You know I'm trying to quit. Fine, give me one. I hate you. Go right here. Stop here. Okay, we can go.
Sam passes out from lack of air. No one notices.
Hey, guess what? I totally landed a kickflip today.
Take a left. Stop here. Okay, let's go. Wow, you really landed a kickflip? That's kind of hot.
Yeah, I almost landed a kickflip.
You know, Famine can do a frontside kickflip.
Such a showoff.
Stop here. Okay, we can go.
Oh, dang it! The grandmas be back! Right.
Left.
Stop!
those grannies.
Stop here. This is where I get off.
Hi, babe. I'll see you around.
Whatever.
What you be looking at? Oh, snap! You be getting late for work, bro. Step on it as hard as you can if we gonna make it. Go, go, go! Yo, faster, faster! Faster, dude! Get up to fifth gear! Yo, faster, faster! Yo, dude, faster! Faster, faster! Faster, dude! Get up to fifth gear! Yo, dude, faster! Yo, faster, faster! Faster, faster! Almost fast enough, dude! Step on it! Almost fast enough, dude! Step on it! Almost fast enough, dude! Step on it! Almost fast enough, dude! Oh, feces! Stop! Stop! Feces! Did we kill somebody? Oh, please let it just be a rock or a hipster or something.
Sam goes out the door to see what happened.
Oh, God.
He only has to follow Death's crying voice.
Feces! This guy wasn't due. He wasn't due. What be I gonna do? Hey, wait a minute. Hey, Sam, can I borrow your last shred of life? Blink twice if yes. All right. Yo, 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 let's do a deal that we can seal, yada, yada, yada. Slap your salmon 57 times in 24 hours or you'll be dead forever. Now, get out of here. I just had to. Anyway, let's get out of here.
Weird. It's another busy day in RoboCorp Inc., where they produce automatic robots for fun, convenience, and most importantly, safety. Finally, Sam makes it to work, and only by having the most terrifying morning of his life. He waggles towards the entrance, still shaky after the events of his trip.
Oh, after I blew my nose off in a laser accident, gave me a robot.
Ah, RoboCorp's proudest and newest invention, the Maidbot. It is rumored to have over 3,000 functions, including pest control, rest control, and guest control. And it can make you a nice cup of coffee. Yes, Sam, do the splits. They'll respect you more. For the 7 billionth time, Sam has lost the key card to his office and has to request a new one from reception. Sam focuses all his brain energy on trying to speak well-formulated sentences.
Hello, Mr. Samuel. How can I help you? Very good, sir. Was there anything else?
You are a wordsmith, Sam.
Of course, sir. Try not to lose it again.
Sam takes the card and heads for his office. We've seen Sam do weirder things.
The elevator is occupied. Sam has no time for waiting.
And then, he meets his old nemesis. Stairs.
Sam goes in the third door to his office area.
Yeah, it is a dangerous job, but the health benefits are awesome, dude! I blew off my leg in a laser accident, and they gave me a new one right away!
I blew off my arm! It was the best day of my life!
This is Ingrid, Sam's secretary. Since Sam never gets any calls or does any actual work, Ingrid has a level 80 warrior in every game ever made. Sam's office. A waste of space, according to everyone ever. Sam doesn't do much at work, simply because his father doesn't let him. According to Samuel Sr., he only has to show up, shut up, and not mess up. This gives Sam plenty of time to sharpen his skills on his favorite game, Flappy Rooster. Yes, he has one here too. Sam, someone knocks on Sam's door. It is Ingrid.
Mr. Samuel, Mr. Welfenberg wants to speak with you.
Also known as Samuel Sr., Sam's dad.
He seems kind of angry. Take the elevator to his office.
The soothing elevator music sets the mood for productivity and not asking questions. All of Sam's interactions with his old man have lately been reduced to short meetings in his office. This is Samuel Sr. He owns Robocorp Inc., and he is tired of the fact that Sam is always late to work. Sam is keeping the morale of his company down, and it is time for him to work for his money.
No more fancy offices. You are starting at the bottom. Today, you start as a lefidium inserter in the storage room. Go down to the basement and get to work!
Sam has done weirder things to impress his dad. Lefidium is a ridiculously rare material packed with energy. It is the key ingredient to the success behind the robots in Robocorp Inc. Its energy is measured in consciousness, and even just a little bit of the stuff could do wonders for artificial intelligence. Despite all his efforts, Sam ends up working for the first time in his life. At least he's alive. Sam's job is ridiculously simple. He has to pull the lever so a chunk of lepidium comes down. Then he has to put the required amount of lepidium in a robot's slot.
Dude, your dad couldn't have picked a worse day to make you work with this stuff. I guess we'll be back in hell in no time.
Sam's vision is blurrier than a Norwegian teenager at a wedding. He decides to blink.
Friggin' skateboard. Aye, let's see here.
Yeah! Even that task gets too hard for Sam. He drops the incredibly toxic material.
No, no, don't breathe that, Sam.
Oh, what I be doing wrong, yo? Let's see. Yeah! Yeah! Gonna do a kickflip now. Friggin' skateboard.
Blink, Sam, blink!
Aye, let's see here. Yeah! Relax my body, bend in my knees.
Blink, Sam, blink!
Yeah! Gonna do a kickflip now.
Blink, Sam, blink!
Friggin' skateboard. Hi, let's see. Yeah! That's my body. Bending my knees.
Sam figures out how to open an automatic door. Impressive, Sam. Sam decides to drink some water, because why not?
Yeah. Gonna do a kickflip now. Friggin' skateboard. Let's see. Yeah! Relax my body. Bending my knees. Oh, what I be doing wrong, yo?
Blink, Sam, blink!
Gonna do a kickflip now. Friggin' skateboard.
Blink, Sam, blink!
Aye, let's see. Yeah! That's my body. Bending my knees. Hey, be doing wrong, yo. Let's see. Yeah! Yeah!
Blink, Sam! Blink!
Gonna do a kick. Oh, what I be doing wrong, yo? Let's see. I'm gonna do a kickflip now. Friggin' skateboard. Alright, let's see. Gonna do a kickflip now. Friggin' skateboard. Hi, let's see. Yeah. Relax my body. Bending my knees. Yo, Sam, I can totally kickflip over that box.
Death says, having never actually landed a kickflip in his entire existence.
Yeah!
Death manages to spill Lephidium all over every robot in the basement.
Oh, no! No, 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 no! Oh, no! No, Sam! What are we gonna do, yo?
Every robot in the basement gets too conscious and escapes. Sam has to get out of work ASAP, and this time with a good excuse.
Don't you see, you doorknob? I was directly involved in waking those things to life.
Sam decides to take a last sip of water before his demise. Electronic door is on lockdown mode. Sam comes to terms with his death and gives up.
No, 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 no. You can't die now, dude.
The electronic door is on lockdown mode. Sam comes to terms with his death and gives up.
No. You can't die now, dude.
It looks like Sam has a plan. The electronic door is on lockdown mode. Sam comes to terms with his death and gives up.
No. You can't die now, dude.
Short-circuits the door! He will live to breathe manually another day!
Gosh darn it! You be right, you beautiful son of a lemur! We do have to stop them! Yeah! That be what I be talking about, dude!
We are in deep feces, fellas. Someone exposed the robots to too much lithidium, and now they are all conscious. They are headed straight for Mushroom Orphanage. Population, 300 lovely kids.
All the robots that became conscious were produced in the last 10 years. That means they have a large arsenal of functions, but are fragile as hell. We will have to use an old and sturdy manual bot to be able to take them down. It is controlled manually.
But gosh Darn it, Johnson! None of us have done anything manually for years!
Oh, I still do things manually sometimes. Maybe I can... Yeah.
Told you she was due in a few hours.
Do we have any volunteers at all for this task? It is not that I believe in you, son, but I've never seen you actually do anything on your own before. So, at this point, I just want to see what happens.
Chillax, bro. You ain't on your own. Yo, yo, yo! We need to blow up those robots before they hurt somebody!
Old Death is pointing the way. Sam don't stop to ask why.
Oh, what the feces! Shoot at that door, yo, so we can keep going. Shoot it two more times, bro. Your gun kind of sucks.
Sam turns that door into toothpicks. He's packing heat.
Oh, for feces sake.
Sam blasts through the door.
Missile.
He's done messing around.
Darn it! That'd be a door we can't blow through! Throw me behind it so I can open it up.
He hurls death without blinking. His only amigo. He has to breathe manually while his friend is gone. He rejoins his day-long friend. It's a touching reunion.
Oh, feces.
Can't get too close to those things. Sam takes out the first robot like he's taking out the trash.
All right, dude. Good to go. What if I just walk over there? That was horrible!
He encounters a running fella. Runner bots are sharp like a straight razor. Gotta pop them before they come too close.
Go, go, go!
Pops them good. He encounters one of them old blue bots. Gotta chuck old Death at him. Suit shuts down. He needs to be more careful.
Yo, I think I fixed it, Sammy. I changed my mind. I changed my... See how I beat that guy up?
big old fella pops up in front of Sam.
Busts him up like he's getting paid for it. Paid in pain. He shoots! He misses. Sam needs to use his shield more.
All right, dude. Good to go.
Wait, I...
Oh, that was
horrible. Walks on backwards. A tactical retreat.
You know what would be cool? If you threw cars around.
Sam needs to use his shield more.
Go, go, go! I changed my mind! Do you see how I beat that guy up?
No problem that don't need no fixing.
Yo, I think I fixed it for you, Sammy. What if I... Oh, man. I think I'm okay.
Sam needs to use his shield more.
Yo, I think I fixed it, Sammy. What if I just walk?
Sam needs to use his shield more.
good to go.
End of the trail. And the orphanage is still standing. Maybe a good day after all.
Whew! No dead kids. Oh, we'd be lucky.
Then the wind turns. There's one last robot needing to be taken care of. The Maidbot.
Oh, feces, dude. Hold on to your flappy rooster.
Gotta watch out for them there missiles. Sam recovers, so does his foe.
Go, go, go! Wait, 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 I ain't ready, I ain't ready!
As Sam recovers, so does his foe.
Go, go, go!
Good old mines start ticking down. Sam gotta think fast.
Jeez, dude. Focus. Oh, yes. 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 Yes.
The Maidbot flies off, starts dropping presents. Covers, so does his foe.
Yo, I think I fixed it for you, Sammy.
Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah. Oh, yeah. You're off, dude. Do it.
Hundred orphans go to heaven, which is a totally nice place, by the way. But death, he caused Satan at least 300 shreds of life. He ain't gonna be happy. And Sam, well, he's got a lot on his mind right about now. I don't know what came over me. Anyway, let's continue the story, shall we?
Feces! I have to disappear forever before he finds me. Just got to do one thing first.
Death has risked a meeting with the one he's trying to avoid for one simple item. The Skatemate 3000! Super easy to do kickflips with.
Oh, I'll be so close. I can almost taste the kickflips.
But then he arrives. The Angel of Darkness. The evil spirit, Mephistopheles, Lucifer, the king of hell, Beelzebub, Satan.
Oh, Satan. Hey, I wasn't. What you be up to, bro?
Oh, you know, Satan things. Busy, busy, busy. Like a fly.
That's a... Yep, good one.
So, I hear you've killed 300 hairless apes.
Kill, as in, I was passing by while it happened, yes, but...
And they were too young to sin. So... They aren't even coming to hell.
I can pay you back. I have 300 shreds.
And where did you get 300 shreds? If you didn't steal them from me.
Weekend jobs.
You are in deep feces.
Meanwhile, Sam is trying to pull himself out of deep feces. There are only a few hours left to his curse.
Oh.
Right as Sam is about to go to bed, she arrives. War.
Can you believe that idiot? He went ahead and got himself thrown in hell jail, so now I have to be both death and war. That's double shifts and no extra pay. Anyway, it says here that you were supposed to die almost 24 hours ago.
Sam tries to say something along the lines of, "No, no, please don't. This is no fun. This is no fun." But his lack of competence in the art of speaking manually only results in this happening. Once again, Sam is in hell.
Come on, I'm supposed to take you to the gate.
Why, hello there, dear sir. Let's see if we can find a job for you. You get to be, the son of the CEO of a huge company. You get your own office, and you get to play Flappy Rooster all day. That'll be all your shreds, dear sir.
Sam remembers that he has none left.
Oh, no shreds of life? Oh, I'm terribly sorry, sir, but this means you have to go to hell jail. Guards! Have a nice day.
Oh, no shreds, eh? Well, it can happen to the best of us, mate. Let's take you to hell jail then, shall we? Such fun.
Take all your related concerns up with upper management.
What's your favorite movie, mate? Mine is It's a Wonderful Life.
There you go, mate. Hope you'll have a good time.
Let's bring him some food.
Take all related concerns up with upper management.
And there he is. Death.
Yo, 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 Sam. Oh, you came to save me. Oh, you truly be a bro. So, what be the plan? Ooh, dude, that be hardcore. But I suppose that be the only way. Aye, when the god comes back, I'll rip him in half and put you inside. You should be able to control him with your manual powers. Here he comes!
Do you like strawberry or chocolate cupcakes, mate? I brought them both just in case.
Heck yeah! It worked, bro! Aight, crush these bombs, and then get your butt to the spot where we met for the first time. He's getting out of here, yo!
As the still warm insides of the guard squeeze against Sam's skin, he thinks about how lucky he is to be rich, so he can pay for all the hours of therapy after this. Sam violently kills a guard. He'll just be reborn as a demon anyway. Of course, Sam doesn't know that.
You are not being very nice right now.
Sam slays another guard, crazy and desperate.
Can't we all just be friends here, sir?
And there goes another one! Deary, Sam! It isn't that hard! This goes on for a while. Let's just see what happens. As Sam recovers, so does his foe.
You're not being very nice right now, sir.
You made it! All right! Let me just open up a portal. Oh, snap.
Silly, hairless ape. I'll make your pain beyond imaginable.
Time to mention those concern-related concerns, Sam.
Oh.
stroll in and out of hell as you please, ape. You can't just stroll in and out of hell as you please, ape. You can't just stroll in and out of hell as you please, ape. You can't just stroll in and out of hell as you please, ape. You can't just stroll in and out of hell as you please, ape.
Thank you. still. God darn it.
Yeah. Ah!